Guys, we're finally here. The hardest stacks and queues problem on CodeMonk. Let's dive into it and see what it has to offer. It's a pretty short question. That's how I like them. You're given an array containing n integers and you have to answer k queries. Each query contains an integer x, which is the index of the ith element of the queue. Write a program to determine the number of segments containing the index x as the leftmost or the rightmost element, and the number at the index x is greater than or equal to each element in that segment. What does this mean? If we have three numbers, 1, 2 and 3, if our input is 3, then we can see the number of possible segments are 3 itself, 3, 2 and 3, 2, 1. In all these three segments, 3 is the greatest element. 3 should either be the rightmost or the leftmost element. So this will return an output of 3. Let's have a closer look. Here you can see our array 4, 2, 1, 3. Let's say our input was 2. So we are going to look at the second element, that is 2. This is one index, remember. How many subsets are there with 2 as the rightmost element and 2 as the greatest element in that subset? So first, let's answer the first question. How many subsets are there with 2 as the rightmost element? That's 4, 2 and 2. However, in 4, 2, 4 is greater than 2. 2 is not the greatest element. So we discount that. So the only possible answer here is 2 itself. Now let's look at the other part of the question. If 2 is the leftmost element, how many valid subsets are there? If 2 is the leftmost element, we have 2, 1, 3, 2, 1 and 2. 2, 1, 3 doesn't count because 3 is greater. 2 and 1 and 2, they are the valid subsets. Note that we're counting 2 twice. Just the standalone element 2 has been counted twice. Now guys, the beauty of practice is that we've solved a very similar question before and we can use the same method to solve this one. I'll link that up in the caption above in case you haven't seen it. But I suggest you try solving this problem for yourselves. Take a while and head on back. So here's what we're going to do. So we're going to pre-calculate the L and R values for each and every single element. L is going to be the number of valid subsets in which that element is the leftmost element. R is going to be the number of valid subsets in which it is the rightmost element. First, let's calculate R. We iterate from left to right, so we start at element 4. Now naturally the R value for 4 is 4, because the only possible subset is 4 itself. We're going to place 4 into our stack along with its count. When we move on to 2, we can see that 2 is not greater than 4. If we had a subset of 4, 2, where 2 is the rightmost element, it would be invalid, which is why 2 goes above 4 in our stack with the count of 1. Our stack is going to be in decreasing order from bottom to top. Similarly, 1 comes in. 1 is not greater than 2. So if 1 is the rightmost element, the only valid subset is 1 itself and its count is 1. Here's where we start seeing the worth of stacks. The rule of our stack is that it has to be in descending order from bottom to top. So when 3 comes in, the rule will get violated unless we start popping out elements. So first, we pop out 1. What does this mean? This means that 1, 3 is going to be a valid subset, which is why we add the count of 1, which is 1, to our current count. Our current count is 1, it's now become 2. 3 is greater than 2 as well, which is why 2's count gets absorbed into 3 as well. And this indicates that 2, 1, 3 is also a valid subset. 4 is not greater than 3. So 3 comes on top of 4 with a count of 3. Now we've successfully calculated the number of subarrays in which 3 is the rightmost element and it is the greatest element. We repeat the same final process with 5. 5 is greater than 3 and we already know 3 has 3 valid subsets. So 5 is going to absorb all those 3 valid subsets. So 5's count now becomes 4. And 5 is greater than 4 as well. So 5 absorbs 4's count as well and has a final count of 5. This indicates that the number of valid subsets for 5 are 4, 2, 1, 3, 5, 2, 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, 3, 5 and 5 itself. One way to calculate the other subset in which each element is the leftmost element is to just flip it around to move from right to left and follow the exact same process. However, we can do better. We can give ourselves a 1-up. Let's see how. We're going to parallelly have a left array while doing the exact same process. We don't need any extra iterations. This left array is initially going to be populated with zeros. We're going to follow the exact same process. We're not going to change anything. So first 4 comes in with a count of 1. Then 2 comes in with a count of 1. 1 comes in with a count of 1. This doesn't affect our left array. Our left array is still 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now when 3 comes in, we're going to count the number of pop operations. So when 3 comes in, we can see that 1 gets popped out. It gets removed from the top of our array. What does this mean? This means if 1 is the leftmost element and the very next element is 3, then the only valid subset for 1 is 1 itself. So we're going to change the count of 1 to 1. Now a second pop operation happens. And this gives us some interesting info. The second number which gets popped has to be greater than the first number which got popped. This means that if that number, in this case 2, was the leftmost element, it would have 2 valid subsets. That's because one is going to be the number itself naturally, and the second is going to be the first number that got popped. That's because that number is less than the current number. That's why we can update the value of 2 to 2. That's because the valid subsets are 2 and 2, 1. Now we can completely forget about 2 and 1. Why? We're at 3 right now. 3 is a greater element than both 2 and 1. So if either of these are the leftmost elements, there cannot be another valid subset after 3. Which is why 2 and 1 are both accounted for. 3 is now in our stack with a value of 3. Now curiously enough, this count also happens to be the number of pop operations minus 1. You'll notice that we did 2 pop operations here for 2 and 1. And the count is 3. Our count is now 1. When 5 comes in, that count goes into 3, which is why 3 becomes 1. And 3 gets popped out. Now 3's count gets added to our current count, which is 4, which is why the element 4 gets popped out with a value of 4. That count indicates that there are 4 valid subsets with 4 as the leftmost element. Those subsets being 4, 4-2, 4-2-1 and 4-2-1-3. There is a final extra step to be done. We've got to pop out all the remaining extra elements from our stack. Now it's just 5 that's left in our stack. So we pop it out and append a value of 1 to 5. By doing this, we've managed to calculate both our L and R values in a single iteration. This right here is an example of code in which we've calculated L and R separately using 2 different for loops. One for loop running from left to right and the other from right to left. The complexity is the same, but as you can see, our time limit has been exceeded. This takes 50% longer to run as opposed to the code we've just discussed. We've got L and R, which are going to hold our final L and R values. And this is going to be our stack. Initially, we're simply going to put the first element into our stack with a count of 1. We're going to iterate through our elements. When an element that's greater than our current element comes in, we've got to start popping out elements. Which is why we decrease the count of top. Top is going to be the uppermost element in our stack. We simply decrease its count. We've already discussed that the count attached to each element is the same as the number of pops minus 1. Which is why this step works. R of minus count plus equals count. And we add the count to the popped element's count. We append the incoming element to the top of the stack with its new count, and we update our L and R values. Finally, if there are any elements left in the stack, we pop them out one by one and we make sure to update our R value while doing so. It's now a simple matter of calculating L plus R minus 1 and displaying it. Why do we calculate L plus R minus 1? That's because the element itself is counted twice, once in L and once in R. And this is just a little quick tip. It's faster to use stdout.write and stdin.readline. These are fast methods of reading input and output. And it's often faster to pre-construct an array and display the entire array as opposed to displaying each element one by one. Let's compile this. We know it works because submit will give us that beautiful tick mark. Guys, I hope you liked the video. It's the hardest stacks and queues problem we've got on CodeMonk. Make sure to hit the three buttons if you feel like you've learned anything. And I'll see you all in the next video.